everyone. I welcome you all to the English session of 7th standard. I am Tulsi Chittari and I will be teaching you today honeycomb of 7th standard. So children, you must be having many doubts in your mind, right? You must be having many questions in your mind, you plus with your parents also, regarding when our schools will start, right? Again, will be there exams or how to study? Who will be our class teacher? Who will be our subject teachers? And just suppose if someone is there to tell you the exact answer, then how your feelings will be? You must be happy, na? Right? You will feel so happy that you got correct answer. So children, here today I am going to tell you a story of a king. Okay, he was a king and he wanted to know the answers of three questions, because he felt if somebody could tell him the correct answers, then he would always achieve success in his life. He would never fail. So for this, what he did? He started sending his messengers to bring the person who will give him proper answer. And plus he also told them to give a reward. So children, now let's see the story. All of you open your textbook, honeycomb lesson number 1, three questions. The thought came to a certain king that he would never fail if he knew three things. These three things were: what is the right time to begin something, which people should he listen to, and what is the most important thing for him to do. So what are the three questions, children? Come on, repeat. Very important questions. First one is, what is the right time to begin something? Means if you want to start some work, what should be the right time, exact time? Okay. Then second, which people he should listen, means which people should be there in front of him to advise him or to suggest any answers. And again, the third question was, what is the important thing for him to do at that particular situation? So these three were the questions of the king. So what happened afterwards? Afterwards, the king, therefore, he sent messengers. Okay, what he did? He sent messengers throughout his kingdom, promising a large sum of money to anyone who would answer these three questions. Understood? So what he did? He sent some messengers throughout his kingdom to find out some person who would properly give him the answers, and king also promised to give him a large sum of money. So what happened? Many wise men came to the king, but they all answered the questions differently. Okay, now just imagine, children, if suppose I am asking a question in a class, then what will happen? Will all of you give the same answer to me? No, answers will be different, right? Some children may give some other answers, some children may give some other answers, and there will be a debate in the class, a type of debate. So here also the same thing is happening. Okay, so in reply to the first question, what was the first question? First question was, what is the right time to begin something? So for this, some said the king must prepare a timetable. Okay, like children, how we prepare a timetable in the class to know which subject comes after which subject? Here also some said the king must prepare a timetable and then follow it strictly. Only in this way, they said, could he do everything at its proper time. But again, others said that it was impossible to decide in advance the right time for doing something. Okay, so again, what happened? Some other people, they opposed this answer. What they said? It is not possible to decide what things happen at what time. Okay, right, tomorrow what will happen, we can't tell in advance. The king should notice all that was going on, avoid foolish pleasures, and always do whatever seemed necessary at that time. Okay, then again there were many people in the court. So again, yet others said that the king needed a council of wise men who could help him act at the proper time. Means again other people said, they suggested him, ki king you should have some wise people in your court who would help you to give the suggestions at proper time. This was because one man could find it impossible to decide correctly without the help of others the right time for every action. Then again debate started. Others said there were some other things which could be urgent. Okay, these things could not wait for the decision of the council. So in order to decide the right time for doing something, it is very necessary to look into the future, and only magicians could do that. The king therefore would have to go to magicians. So here what the people suggested, some of the people suggested that no one can tell what is going to happen in the future. So but only magicians can tell you. So you better call a magician in your court so that he may help you to find out the decision. Now to the next question. Next question was what? Yes, to which people he should listen. Okay, so to the next question. But then others said that there were some things which could be urgent. Okay, so to the next question, the answer was, some said that the people most necessary to the king were his counselors. Okay, so here comes the people. King's question was which people he should listen. So again for this there was a debate type. Some answered that the king should have some counselors. Okay, and again some people said that they should have priest, and again few others choose the doctors, and yet others said that his soldiers were the most necessary. Now see, so many answers he is getting for one single question, children. Some are saying he should have counselors, others are saying he should have priest, again some others are saying he should have doctors, and some are saying he should have soldiers. So for each question he is getting number of answers. Now to the third question. What was the third question? Third question was important thing for him to do. Okay, so to the third question, again some people suggested him that he should go for science subject. He should discover more and more science. He should learn more science subject well. Again others said no, he should choose fighting, and again some others said that he should worship the religious. Okay, so as the answers to these questions were so different, each one of them gave different answers, right? So as the answers of these questions were so different, the king was not satisfied and he gave no reward. He was not satisfied with the answers, as he did not get any one proper answer. So he was not satisfied and he did not give any reward to anyone. Instead what he did? Instead he decided to seek the advice of a certain hermit. Here hermit means who, children? Hermit means a person who lives alone and leads a simple life. Like for example Rishi, you know Rishi Muni, how do they stay in forest? Same way. So here in English we'll call him as a hermit. Hermit is a person who lives alone and leads a very simple life. So now the king decided to go to visit a hermit. So now just see what is happening. Okay, the hermit lived in a wood, means the hermit, he used to live in a forest which he never left. He saw no one but simple people, and so the king put on ordinary clothes. Now as the king, he was going to hermit's house in the forest. So what he should do? Should he wear his all that rich dresses? No, na. So he wore simple ordinary clothes so that the hermit could not recognize him. And before he reached the hermit's hut, what he did? He left his horse with his bodyguard and went alone. Okay, so before he went to the hermit's hut, he left his horse with his bodyguard and he went alone. Now as the king came near the hermit's hut, he saw the hermit digging the ground in front of his hut. So what did he saw? He saw the hermit was digging the ground in front of his hurt. He greeted the king and continued digging. So now here the hermit, he recognized the king. But what actions were there? He did not do any actions. He was just continuing. He just greeted the king and he started continuing his work. The hermit was very old and weak, and as he worked, he breathed heavily. Okay. The king went up to the hermit and said, now see what is the king saying. Okay. The king went up to the hermit and said, I have come to you, wise hermit, to ask you to answer these three questions. So now he is asking the hermit that I came to you, and you please, can you answer me these three questions? First one, how can I learn to do the right thing at the right time? Okay. Again, who are the people I need the most, and what affairs are the most important for me? Now just see, the hermit, he just listened to the king, but he did not speak. He just went on digging and digging. Then the king, what he did? He said, you are tired, said the king. Let me take the spade and work in your place. Okay. So what he is saying to the hermit? He is saying, you are very tired, so let me do your work. Please, you give me your spade, I will dig for you. Thanks, said the hermit, giving the king his spade. Then he sat down on the ground. So now what hermit did? He gave his spade to the king and he sat down on the ground for rest. See the picture here, children. Okay. Here he is the king and he is the hermit. The hermit, how is looking? He is looking very old and tired. And this king, he is asking him for the spade, and this hermit, he is giving him the spade. Next one. When the king had dug two beds, he stopped and repeated his question. Now the king, he is digging the ground. Okay. So now again he stopped in between and he repeated his question. The hermit gave no answer, but stood up, stretching out his hands for the spade, and said, now you rest, let me work. Okay. So now when the king is digging the ground, again he is asking the questions to the hermit. And what the hermit is doing? He just stood up and he told the king to just give him his spade. And he said, now you rest, let me work. But the king did not give him the spade and continued to dig. Okay. One hour passed, then another. The sun went down behind the trees. And at last, the king stuck the spade into the ground and said, I came to you, wise man, for an answer for my questions. If you can give me no answer, tell me so, I will return my home. So at last what happened? The king, what he said? Finally, he said to hermit that if you want to tell me the answers, you tell me, or otherwise I will go back to my home. Then just see suddenly what happens. Suddenly here comes someone running, said the hermit. Now children, just we'll check these answers, okay? Can you tell me the answer? Why did the king wanted to know the answers of the three questions? Why? Yes, because he wanted to achieve success. He never wanted to fail, right? That's why he wanted to know the answers to his three questions. Second one, messengers were sent throughout the kingdom. Tell me why the messengers were sent throughout the kingdom? Yes, to Anna. Why? Because to find the answers to the questions of the king. Okay. Now we'll see the next part. Now what is happening? Okay. The king turned round and saw a bearded man running towards them. Okay. His hands were pressed against the stomach, from which blood was flowing. When he reached the king, he fainted and he fell to the ground. So what did the king saw? He saw a man, a bearded man, and his hands were pressed on his stomach, through which blood was flowing. Okay. And when he reached near the king, he just fainted and fell on the ground. Now the king and hermit, just see what they are doing. The king and the hermit removed the man's clothing. Okay. Since he was bleeding, so what they did? They removed the man's clothing, and they found a large wound in his stomach. So the king he washed and he covered it with his handkerchief. But the blood could not stop flowing. The king redressed the wound until at last the bleeding stopped. So what happened? He was wounded so much that it was continuously bleeding and continuously bleeding. Though he was changing and changing with the kerchief, but still the blood was flowing. So now what they have to do? Again he redressed. Redressed means dressed again and until the last bleeding stopped. Now the man felt better, okay? He felt better and he asked for something to drink. He was very thirsty, so he asked him something to drink. The king bought some fresh water and he gave it to him. So by this time the sun had set and the air was cool. The king, with the hermit's help, he carried the wounded man into the hut and laid him on the bed. So what he did? He, with the help of hermit, they took this wounded man to the hut and they laid him on the bed. The man closed his eyes and lay quietly. The king, tired by his work and the work he had done, lay down on the floor and slept throughout the night. So the king, the whole day he was doing the work, so he got so much tired that he just laid on the floor and he slept throughout the night. When he awoke, so just see what is happening when he awoke. When he awoke, it was several minutes before he could remember. See here the picture, okay, how the both this hermit and the king, how they are helping the wounded man, where he was or who the strange bearded man lying on the bed was. Now, forgive me, said the bearded man in a weak voice when he saw that the king was awake. So when the king was awake, what happened? Just then that bearded man, he came to him and he told him to please forgive me. Then what did the king reply? The king replied, I do not know you and have nothing to forgive. So what he said, I do not know you and have nothing to forgive you for, said the king. Means king is saying, I don't know you, so how can I forgive you? Then what is this man saying? Listen, you do not know me, but I know you. I am that enemy of yours who swore revenge on you because you put my brother to death and seized my property. I knew you had gone all alone to see that hermit and I made up my mind to kill you on your way to home. So what this man is saying, ki you don't know me, but I know you very well, okay, because you are the one who put my brother to death, means you killed my brother and you seized my property. So I wanted to take a revenge, I wanted to kill you. That's why I made up a mind to kill you on your way home. But the day passed and you did not return. So I left my hiding place and I came upon your bodyguard who recognized me and wounded me. So what he is saying? So I came up to your bodyguard, but the bodyguard, he recognized me and he wounded me. I escaped from him, but I should have died. So what he is saying? From your body he wounded me and from him I tried to escape from him, but you have helped me. But I should have died if you had not dressed my wounds. I wish to kill you and you have saved my life. So he is telling, I wish to kill you, my intention was to kill you, but king, you only saved my life. Now I wish to kill you and you have saved my life. Now if I live, I will serve you as your most faithful servant and will order my sons to do the same. Okay, so what he is saying, as you have saved my life, so if I live, I will serve you as your most faithful servant and even I will tell my sons also to do the same thing for you. So king, please forgive me. Now the king was very happy to have made peace. Okay, the king was very happy to have made peace with his enemy so easily and to have won him over as a friend. He not only forgave him, but said he would send his servants and his own doctor to look after him, and he promised to give back the man his property. So what he said? So he said ki, the king said he has forgiven him and also he would send his servants to his home with the doctors to look after him, and he also promised to give back his property. Leaving the wounded man, the king went out of the hut and looked round for the hermit. Now what happened? The king, he left the wounded man and he went out of the hut and looked round for the hermit. Before going away, he wished once more to get answer to his question. So before leaving the hut of the hermit, he wished that at least he should meet once the hermit, and so that he may get the answers of his three questions. So once he to get the answers of his question, the hermit was on his knees sowing seeds in the beds that had been dug the day before. So what he was doing, the hermit? He was sowing the seeds in the beds that was dug the day before. The king went up to the hermit and said, "For the last time, I beg you to answer my questions, wise man." So what he is saying? He is saying to the hermit, "This is the last time. Please answer my questions." He is begging to the hermit to answer the questions. Now what the hermit is saying? Okay, "You have already been answered," said the hermit, till bending down to the ground and looking up at the king as he stood before him. So he is saying, hermit is saying that you have already been answered by doing his continuing with his work. The king was very shocked. He said, "How I have been answered? What do you mean?" "Do you not see?" replied the hermit. "If you had not pitied my weakness yesterday and had not dug these beds for me, you would have gone away." So how he is replying? See, if yesterday you would have not helped me, then what would happen? You would have gone away. Then that man would have attacked you. Okay, so if you have not helped me, you would have gone back and that man would have attacked you. Then that, and you would have wished you had stayed with me. So the most important thing was when you were digging the beds. So he is saying at that moment the most important time was when you were digging the beds, and I was the most important man. Okay, so he is saying that time the most important time for you was when you were digging the beds, and I was the most important man to you. This is the answer of the second question. And to do me good was your most important business. So third answer you got, that is, to do me a favor, to help me, was the most important business. Afterwards, when the man ran to us, now again he is giving one more example. Okay, afterwards when the man ran to us, the most important time was when you were caring for him. Okay, because if you had not dressed his wounds, he would have died without having made peaceful with you. So he was the most important man at that time, and what you did for him was the most important business. In such way, the hermit is answering to his questions. Remember then, there is only one time that is important, and that time is now. It is most important time because it is the only time we have any power to act. Means what he is saying? Whatever he is saying, the important thing at that moment is the time. Time is very precious, children. Okay, you should not waste your time. Whatever important decisions you have to take, you should take at appropriate time. Means at present, you should not wait for the future, or you should not wait for tomorrow. Okay, whatever important decisions you want to take, take it today. Do not depend on tomorrow. Like for example, I would like to say that in this present situation, what is important for you? Come on, can you tell me? Yes, the important thing for you is to keep yourself healthy, be safe at home, eat healthy food. Okay, and which second question is, which peoples are important for you? That people important for you are your parents. Okay, you should listen to your parents and you should follow their instructions properly. And again, most important thing, third point, third question, what important thing is, what is the important thing for you is, the important thing is that you should take proper precautions at this time. Do not go outside unnecessarily and be happy. Okay, so even the hermit is saying the that there is only one time that is important, and that is now. Now means present. Whatever you are doing in present is very important, and whatever decisions you want to take, you take it finally today only. Don't wait for tomorrow, as time and tide waits for nobody. The most necessary person is the person you are with a particular moment, for no one knows what will happen in the future and whether we will meet anyone else. So the most important business is to do that person good, because we are sent into this world for the purpose, for that purpose alone. Means what? Nobody knows about future, children, correct? Do you know what will happen tomorrow? No, even I will not know what is going to happen tomorrow. So no one can tell you exactly what will happen tomorrow. Today we can talk with each other, we can do chatting, we can communicate, but tomorrow I don't know. Even among ourselves, who is there, who will not be there? Can anybody say? No. So whatever today you have, the day which you got today in your hand, live it with happily and satisfied. Okay, be thankful to the God that at least one time in a day before going to sleep, just thankful for to the God for giving you this such a wonderful day. And if you do the same, and if you do good for someone, it will definitely come back to you. So children, let's answer these questions. Now we have completed our lesson. Okay, complete the following sentence by adding the appropriate parts of the sentences given in the box. Many wise men answered the king's question. Come on, tell me what will be the answer of this question. But their answers were so varied that the king was not satisfied. Okay, someone suggested that there should be a council of wise men. Next one, what is the answer for this? Someone suggested that there should be a council of wise men. Why? To help the king act at the right time. Now again, third one, someone else suggested that the king should have a timetable. So why the king should have a timetable? So that he can follow it strictly. Okay, now next one, the king requested the hermit. What did the king requested the hermit? To answer three questions. The king washed and dressed the bearded man's wound. So the last and final answer was, but the bleeding would not stop. Now children, we'll go to match the pairs. Okay, match the items of list A with list B. Okay, come on, tell me the answers of wounded. What is the answer of wounded? Wounded means severely injured. Awoke means to got up from the sleep. Third one, forgive means to pardon. Okay, then faithful means loyal. Again, pity means feel sorry for. Beds means small patches of ground for the plants. And last, return means to give back. So children, today you have seen the story. Hope you all understood the story. Okay, so I'll conclude my lesson, and for the next session we'll go through the other exercise of the lessons of this lesson. So I thank you very much for this day. Have a nice day.